Is the mark partition as active option grayed out when trying to make a partition active using the disk management utility? Then you are at the right place, as we have the ways to fix the issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. The active partition is the main partition of the hard drive that has a Windows operating system, and it can be set as a bootable partition. On every hard drive, you can pick only one primary partition to be the active or bootable one. You can't set another drive as active on the same hard drive. When some users tried to make a partition active using the disk management utility, they noticed that the mark partition as active option was grayed out. In this video, we will discuss this issue and see how it can be resolved. Let's get started. Method 1. Mark partition as primary. It is known that the operating system and bootable file should be in one drive, and that the drive should be marked as an active primary partition. Suppose the partition is not primary, you will not be able to set it to active. In this scenario, we will use the diskpart tool to convert a logical partition to primary. Here we are going to use the Windows built-in diskpart tool to convert the logical drive to a primary partition. Press the Windows key. Type command prompt in the search bar, right-click and select Run as Administrator. Click Yes when prompted by UAC. Type diskpart in the command prompt and press the Enter button. Type list disk in the diskpart prompt to check the number of disks. Type select disk N. N is a disk number. Type list partition. Type select partition. Partition number. Here, we are going to delete the partition. For that, type delete partition to make space free. Type create partition primary. Method 2. Uninstall the Windows update. A bug in the code of the operating system can cause a lot of trouble for the user. Some users who updated their Windows OS reported the issue. So uninstall the Windows update following this link and see. If some updates were partially downloaded, you might want to delete the downloaded, failed or pending Windows updates and see if that helps. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.